watching all the plastic leave this facility and being shipped off across Canada to be recycled, it was hard to watch. So being able to actually bring that recycling onto this facility and be doing it here locally in Edmonton for all of our customers is really exciting to see. My name is Ivana Moldenhauer, and I'm the Health, Safety, and Environment Manager at RBW. When you're dealing with recycled plastic, you're competing with virgin plastic in the market, and it's very cheap to process virgin plastic, whereas, as you've seen from our process here, it's very expensive and labor-intensive to recycle plastic. It was important to show that you can actually sort the waste, treat it, and actually recycle it all in one facility without having to ship it off-site.
Recycled high-density polyethylene, or HDPE, has long had a tough reputation. Many people assume it's lower quality than new plastic, with mixed colors, odd smells, or leftover impurities. That makes it harder to resell, even though the plastic itself is basically identical. RBW Waste Management wants to change that. They collect used HDPE from oil and gas sites across Western Canada. They sort it, wash it, shred it into strips, grind it into flakes, and then melt it into durable 2x4 and 4x4 plastic logs. Those logs become products, like picnic tables, garden beds, and pallets, turning post-industrial waste into a long-lasting material. Since 2022, the project has prevented over 1,200 tons of carbon emissions, about 292 tons each year, the equivalent of taking 63 passenger vehicles off the road.
We're locally processing this material. We are no longer having to ship this material across Canada, so the emissions that were related to that are eliminated. Also, because this is contaminated material, we're ensuring by washing this material that all of the contamination is contained and is not able to be released into the environment. RBW Waste Management received $663,000 from Emissions Reduction Alberta through the Government of Alberta, to a total project cost of almost $1.5 million.